one of them videos again, we get loads of dislikes. I've probably lost loads of people already. Dislike, don't like your voice, get off my screen. Let's click onto something that someone's ripped off a Family Guy or something. Anyway, if you're still watching, maybe that's because you've got ammunition to fire against me and you want me to hate and you want me to say something wrong and then just say in the comment section of why I'm a horrible person. Nah. Then there's the rest of you who are brilliant. I know that not everyone thinks alike. And you are the royal jelly of the YouTube beehive. You're brilliant. Anyway, I'm talking about a case at the moment which has got me quite fired up. And it's the case of the cyclist and the pedestrian on the path. And there's a lady walking on a path. There's a lady on a bicycle. And the lady pedestrian starts shouting and swearing at the cyclist on the path, waving around, walking in front of her, waving around, at one point looking as if she made contact with the cyclist. The cyclist falls into the road and dies because they get run over. Now, this is where I lose more subscribers and viewers and get more dislikes because I'm going to use the word facts. Oh, your feelings. Anyway, stick with me, royal jelly. You'll know where this is going, probably. Well, anyway, the pedestrian was a fat cow. And the cyclist was an old lady, a retired midwife. We're not talking about some young kid walking towards them, like messing around. We're not talking about a couple of kids on a BMX, you know, giving a croggy or a crossbar and like shouting and whooping like this and letting off foghorns or something. No. The pedestrian was 49 years old. Lady on the bicycle, much older than that, I think. So I think she was in her late 60s, maybe 70s. I forget. Now, there's people defending the pedestrian because she's got cerebral palsy and she's partially sighted. No, that does not exonerate you from doing the wrong thing. If you are allowed to be out in public and you're allowed to be on your own, you've got to take responsibility for yourself. And that does not mean that you should get away with doing anything you like just because you've got some sort of disability or disorder. If you cause the harm or the death of somebody from your actions, you should be treated like everybody else. Proper equality. You should be treated like everybody else. I've probably just got a few more dislikes for saying that, but it's true. And unfortunately, you've got to give analogies. You've got to say to these people, "Oh, well, how about if you was working next to somebody and say that you worked in an electronics factory soldering things together. I'm from the UK, we don't make anything anymore. You work in a factory making food or something and you're dealing with hot oil. And the person next to you has got ADHD or some sort of, something. And the sudden starts to go in front of you whilst you're handling hot oil or solder. And the skin on your hands and arms dissolves. And you lose your job because obviously you've got no arms left. I mean, what are you supposed to do? Go, oh, well, Jackie, she had ADHD, you know. It was a, never mind. Oh, she was a lovely girl, really. I'm never going to be able to feel anything ever again because I've got no arms left, but she was a lovely lass. That's not going to happen, is it? You're going to want some kind of compensation. You're going to want some kind of punishment for Jackie. I don't know why I thought the word Jackie. I think the word Jackie is just a funny name. Jackie! Especially when you say it with like a Scouse accent. Anyway, I miss Brookside just for Jimmy and Jackie. You're not going to want that. Anyway, there's people, yeah, defending the pedestrian. She was a fat cow who still went on to do a shopping at Sainsbury's. After pushing somebody in the road and watching that person get run over, she goes and does her shopping at Sainsbury's. Anyway, the poor lady on the bike, on the bicycle, kind of just, I can't reiterate enough how slow motion this actually was. If you watch the CCTV yourself, this is all facts. You can see it happen slowly. You can see the pedestrian woman has plenty of time to either just carry on walking or get out the way. And if she wants to say something, she shouldn't have to flipping wave her arm around and shout it. There's no visual, there's only visuals. There's no audible sound for the CCTV. But these are the facts. There's people then blaming the cyclist. Ooh, she shouldn't have been on the path anyway. There's the old adage, two wrongs don't make a right. That's all I've got really to say about that, isn't it? You know, it was a shared path, but, you know, people are going to blame the cyclist. She's an old lady on a bike. It wasn't the flipping kids on a BMX giving a croggy or a flipping crossbar. flying 100 mile an hour down the path and the pedestrian had to leap out the way, because that would be the normal reaction, wouldn't it? You'd get out the way if you felt you was in danger. You'd just start waving your arms around and shouting right in front of an oncoming vehicle. Do you? Very weird. And then there's people blaming the council, saying, oh, it should be adequately marked, the pavement, because, oh, cyclists, we are so injured all the time. Ooh. Flipping it, and when they go on dirt, they, oh, it's like Jeremy Vaughan. Oh, can you imagine? Why can't Jeremy Vaughan be dead? Anyway. More dislikes. Oh, I like Jeremy Vaughan. Anyway, that's my take on it. And she's appealing, already saying that she was partially sighted. Partially sighted, yet from ages away, she still saw this bike coming towards her very, very slowly. It's ridiculous how people will use anything to get out of trouble and even illnesses, and they'll get away with it. It makes you not want to go out, ever. Because you don't know if you're going to be either at work or walking down the street, some idiots who thinks they can use their flipping disability or differences or whatever as a card against you to make it your fault and get away with it. It makes me so cross. So I hope she feels a repeal. People go away for much longer for less. I'm not a fan of, what's his name? I want to say Bellend. It's not Bellend. Oh, what's his name? Oh, Belfield, Alex Belfield. I'm not a fan of him. But he went away for 5 years for saying nasty things on the internet. 5 years for just saying nasty things. Not very much from what we can gather anyway. And back to Jeremy Vaughan again. Ugh. Anyway, what's your comments? What's your thoughts? Let me know in the comment section down below. But please watch the facts. Please have a proper opinion on facts of what actually happened. Lady walking on a path. Okay. All right, she's got cerebral palsy and she's wearing glasses. So what? Lady on a bike going very, very slowly on an allegedly joint footpath. Pedestrian walks in front of a cyclist, waving her arm, looking at one point as if she made contact with a cyclist. Cyclist dies in front of her, gets run over. Pedestrian goes off to do my shopping at Sainsbury's. Bye! Ridiculous. Maybe not so dramatic as that. But she goes out to do a shopping. How can you do that? Ugh. Anyway, thanks for watching, Scrubs. Bye.